In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to this holy sacrifice of the Mass, being celebrated in the Grotto of Lourdes, with the Immaculate Conception watching over us. I would like to welcome four priests, four Palatine Fathers, who are originally from India, but ministering in Switzerland in German. And so now they are here to attend the English Mass. Welcome. And I have with us Father Vincenzo, who will be the principal concelebrant, who is an Italian chaplain here in Lourdes. This large candle burns in prayer for pilgrims and pilgrimages that would normally be here at this time, notably Edinburgh, Dunkeld, Nottingham, and leaving today would have been the pilgrimage from Down and Connor. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Hear the word of the Lord, princes of Sodom. Listen to the instructions of our God, people of Gomorrah. What care I for the number of your sacrifices, says the Lord? I have had enough of whole burnt rams and fat of fatlings. In the blood of calves, lambs, and goats, I find no pleasure. When you come in to visit me, who asks these things of you? Trample my courts no more. Bring no more worthless offerings. Your incense is loathsome to me. New moon and Sabbath, calling of assemblies, octaves with wickedness, these I cannot bear. Your new moons and festivals I detest. They weigh me down. I tire of the Lord. When you spread out your hands, I close my eyes to you. Though you pray, the more I will not listen. Your hands are full of blood. Wash yourselves clean. Put away your misdeeds from before my eyes, because doing evil, learn to do good. Make justice your aim, redress the wrong, hear the orphan's plea, defend the widow. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, the response. To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. I take from your house no bullock, no goats out of your fold.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth, though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you?
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
When you do these things, shall I be deaf to it? Or do you think that I am like yourself? I will correct you by drawing them up before your eyes. He that offers praise has a sacrifice, glorifies me. And to him that goes the right way, I will show the salvation of God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his apostles, "Do not think that I have come to bring peace upon the earth. I have come to bring not peace, but the sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And one's enemies will be those of his household. Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is righteous will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink because he is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." When Jesus finished giving these commands to his 12 disciples, he he went away from that place to teach and to preach in their towns. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The message of this gospel is difficult to hear. Do not think that I have come to bring peace upon the earth. I have come to bring not peace, but the sword. Very harsh words. It is harsh and can appear to be in contradiction to John 14:27, where Christ says, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Not as the world gives do I give you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid." And so there seems to be a contradiction. But we need to understand what the peace of Christ is. It is not, as many believe, about peace in the world, there being no wars, no conflicts, peace among everyone. The peace of Christ is an inner peace, a centeredness, that despite everything that is going on around us, despite the chaos and the confusion, our hearts are not troubled nor afraid. Christ is telling us that he did not come to give the world peace, but a personal, individual peace. The world we know is at odds with Christianity. We can experience criticism and attack, even from those close to us. The peace of Christ enables us to withstand the attacks of the world and sometimes of loved ones. It gives us the courage to continue on our path. And so when Christ says, "It is not peace I have come to bring, but a sword," it is the sword of righteousness that cuts off evil at its roots. Perhaps a good example today is abortion. The world embraces it. We may have family and friends who are in favor of it and pressure us to accept it. We must have that personal peace of Christ that allows us to resist the chaos around us and be centered in the peace of Christ, to oppose the evil that perhaps even loved ones have come to embrace. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look upon the offerings of the church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Nicholas, our Bishop, Bishop Edward, his brother in Christ, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters, our grandfather that sleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Saint Joseph, her husband, with the blessed angels, apostles, with Saint Bernadette, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
May this meeting of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring to life to those of us who receive. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Thank you. Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with, oh, I'm sorry, we have an announcement. Yes.
The Mass in English is celebrated daily at the Grotto at 5 p.m. However, on Wednesday, the 15th of July, as an exception, the Mass in English will be celebrated at 9 a.m. at the Grotto, and the 5 p.m. Mass will be cancelled. On Thursday, the 16th of July, due to the Lourdes United program, there will be 3 international Masses celebrated at the Grotto at 7 a.m., 10 a.m., and 7:30 p.m. Please ask at the Information Center for more details. Thank you.
Thursday is the anniversary of the last day of apparitions, and Lourdes is launching a worldwide e-pilgrimage. And so if you're going to be here, that is great. If you're not, tell your friends and family, and you can check on our website and on different television stations to follow the events that go through the entire day on Thursday. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.